Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is impermanent loss in crypto. Well, impermanent losses are one of the risks concerned with liquidity pools in DeFi. And to state its definition, it refers to the difference in value between funds held in AMM and the funds held in your wallet. Impermanent loss occurs when the value of funds staked to the AMM fluctuates drastically. The more significant the price fluctuation is, the greater impermanent loss can be. Confused? Let's understand this concept one step at a time with an example. I'm assuming that you're aware of basic understanding of concepts like DeFi and yield farming. If not, no worries, I've got you covered with my two videos, link for each can be found in the description below. So, yield farming, also called as liquidity mining, in DeFi has been at the heart of the market's explosion, led by automated market making or AMM protocols. Some projects like Uniswap, SushiSwap, and Balancer are known as decentralized exchanges and they rely on such AMM protocols. Their platforms allow traders to easily swap tokens in completely decentralized and seamless manner. This complete cycle is made possible by liquidity providers, that is, the users who deposit particular crypto assets to the platform, thereby providing liquidity for other assets to be exchanged. The liquidity providers are incentivized to deposit or lock in their assets because they earn transaction fees generated by traders swapping tokens on a given platform. And if seen from the perspective of liquidity providers or those who are locking their tokens into a DeFi protocol, the transaction fees they earn are like a yield, and the value of this yield fluctuates as it depends on protocol's usage and volume. With this being the foundational understanding, let's dig deeper into how AMM liquidity pools work. So, in order for users of an AMM-powered protocol to swap tokens, there needs to be pools of liquidity available for them. For example, if John wants to sell 1 Ethereum for USDT, and for simplicity's sake, if we say 1 Ethereum is trading for 1000 USDT and there's no platform fee, then there needs to be a liquidity pool that can take 1 Ethereum and give 1000 USDT and vice versa. So, as trading volume surges, so does the need for such liquidity. And that is where those who are looking to be liquidity providers come in. These users can deposit the two digital currencies of a pair, in this case it is Ethereum and USDT, to the protocol's relevant pools in a predetermined ratio, which in most cases is 50-50. Now, to understand things better, let's take another example. If a liquidity provider with 10 Ethereum wishes to add liquidity to an Ethereum USDT pool with a 50-50 ratio, they will need to deposit 10 Ethereum and 10,000 USDT by still assuming that 1 Ethereum is equal to 1000 USDT. If the pool they commit to has a total of 100,000 USDT worth of assets, let's say 50 Ethereum and 50,000 USDT, their share will be equal to 20% by this simple equation. Also, the percentage of the liquidity provider's share in a given pool is important to note because when the liquidity provider commits or deposits their assets to the liquidity pool via smart contract, they will automatically be issued liquidity pools tokens, and these tokens are entitled to the liquidity provider to withdraw their share of pool at any time, which is 20% of the pool in our stated example. Now, this is where the concept of impermanent loss comes into play. Since liquidity providers are entitled to their share of the pool and not to a specific number of tokens, they are exposed to another layer of risk, which is what we call as impermanent loss. And it happens when the price of your deposited assets changes compared to when you deposited them. Remember here, the bigger this change is, the more you are exposed to the impermanent loss. And in this case, the loss means less dollar value at the time of withdrawal than at the time of deposit. Also, do note that it is called impermanent because as long as cryptos can return to the price when they were deposited on the AMM, no loss occurs, and the liquidity providers also get 100% of the trading fees. Next, let's understand how to calculate impermanent loss. So, in our example, the price of 1 Ethereum was 1000 USDT at the time. But let's say the price doubles and 1 Ethereum starts trading at 2000 USDT. Since the pool is adjusted by an algorithm, it uses a formula to manage assets. The most basic and widely used one is the constant product formula, which is popularized by Uniswap. In simple terms, the formula states that product of Ethereum liquidity and token liquidity results in constant product. Using figures from our example, which is based on 50 Ethereum and 50,000 USDT, we get 2.5 million. Similarly, the price of Ethereum in the pool can be obtained with this formula. And on applying our example figures, we get 1000 USDT, which is the original price of 1 Ethereum. Now, when the price of Ethereum changes to 2000 USDT, we can use these formulas to ascertain the ratio of Ethereum and USDT held in the pool by calculating Ethereum liquidity and token liquidity using the following formulas. Further, on applying the data from our example here, along with the new price of 2000 USDT per Ethereum, it gets us approximately 35.355 Ethereum and approximately 70,710 USDT. So, we can confirm the accuracy of this by using the very first equation we discussed to arrive at the same constant product of 2.5 million, which can be seen as follows, which further proves as the same as our original constant product. Hence, after the price changes, assuming all factors remain constant, the pool will have roughly 35 Ethereum and 70,710 USDT, compared to the original 50 Ethereum and 50,000 USDT. And if at this time the liquidity provider wishes to withdraw their assets from the pool, they will exchange their liquidity provider tokens for the 20% share they own. Taking their share from updated amounts of each assets in the pool, they will get 7 Ethereum, that is 20% of 35 Ethereum, and 14,142 Ethereum, that is 20% of 70,710 USDT. Now, the total value of the assets withdrawn equals 7 into 2000 plus 14,142 USDT, which is 28,142 USDT. However, now in this case, if the user simply held their 10 Ethereum and 10,000 USDT, instead of depositing these assets into a DeFi protocol, they actually would have gained more. Assuming Ethereum doubled in price from 1000 USDT to 2000 USDT, the user's non-deposited assets would have been valued at 30,000 USDT, simply as 10 into 2000 plus 10,000 USDT equals to 30,000 USDT. That difference, which occurs because of the way AMM platforms manage their asset ratios, is what is known as impermanent loss. So, now that we know what is impermanent loss and how to calculate it, let's talk about how you can avoid impermanent loss. Well, although there is no way to avoid impermanent loss completely, liquidity providers can still take a few measures to mitigate the risk. Number 1. Use stablecoin pairs. Now, by providing liquidity in stablecoin pairs is the best bet against impermanent loss. Since stablecoin's value doesn't fluctuate much, they present low arbitrage opportunities and thus decreasing the risk. However, at the same time, liquidity providers who hold stablecoins cannot enjoy the rise in the crypto market. Number 2. Avoid volatile pairs. Instead of choosing crypto with unstable or volatile history, pick up pairs that don't expose liquidity to impermanent loss. Number 3. Thoroughly search the market. Crypto markets are highly volatile, hence it is normal that deposited assets move up or down in value. However, liquidity providers must know when to pull out their cryptocurrencies before the price deviates too far away from the initial rate. Lastly, as a conclusion, I'd like to say that impermanent loss is the sole reason why big financial institutions don't enter the liquidity pools. This issue should be solved if AMMs are to achieve widespread adoption among businesses and individuals worldwide. And though various folks of Uniswap have come up in the recent months that try to solve this issue, we are yet to see a clear winner who can help avoid this loss of liquidity. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.